My name is John Heuer. I am a resident currently of North Carolina. In 1971, I was indicted for draft evasion, refusing to serve in the Army. Richard Nixon was president at the time. I had served in Vietnam as a merchant seaman in 1968, registered with the U.S. Coast Guard. And coming to Toronto in 1971, October, had a wonderful reception by friends and family and everyone that I met in Toronto. Eventually, Richard Nixon resigned the presidency in disgrace, and Gerry Ford became president, offered a provisional pardon for Vietnam-era war resistors. I returned to the United States to restore my good citizenship. Eventually served as a VISTA volunteer doing low-income rural home rehabilitation in North Carolina, and met a young North Carolina woman who didn't like winter time, so we stayed in North Carolina and raised our boys there. After the U.S. invasion of Iraq, I returned to peace activism. When I retired from the University of North Carolina, I've been since then been working as a full-time volunteer for Veterans for Peace, now serving as a national board secretary. This June, opportunity to come up to Toronto to visit with family and friends. Very delighted to meet peace activists in the Toronto area, working with U.S. resistors and sympathetic Canadian activists. So it's really a thrill for me to be back here in Toronto to visit old friends and make new friends. My message is multifold, one primarily of gratitude for your work. Hearing your stories about a possibility of a change in the Canadian government that could become more hospitable to U.S. war resistors, it's grieved me to, since my reception was so hospitable back in 1971, that the Canadian government is now deporting U.S. war resistors. So I'm very encouraged by your efforts. The work that you folks are doing here in Toronto is just so very exciting and encouraging, and I'm very grateful, as we all are everywhere, for your efforts. Veterans for Peace was founded in 1985. We have about 100 chapters in the U.S. We also have chapters internationally in Vietnam and in London. We are encouraged by the work that we've been doing in the U.S., but understand that we'll take a international effort across international lines. And Veterans for Peace welcomes activists and veterans anywhere and everywhere. Well, as a former Canadian now living in the United States, I've been advocating for Canadian-style health care for citizens in the U.S. It's been at odds with certainly the claims of wanting to care for returning troops and veterans and then recently exposed scandals of veterans dying while on waiting lists to see Veterans Administration physicians, scandals of forged waiting lists, 22 veterans estimated to take their own lives. It's a terrible tragedy. It needs more focus here in Canada, in the U.S., and across international lines. We need to know about the hypocrisy of politicians willing to send young men and women off to serve in war and then being so tragically neglectful of them when they return.